What up, everybody? This is your boy Black Magus and car blogging. It's windy as hell and looks like it's gonna be another day where we get a bunch of like crazy ass storms. Yesterday here in the DC area, it stormed like crazy for the first half of the day. Back in like late afternoon, kind of calmed down, but then wake up this morning, I saw that it was probably raining overnight as well. Get out on the roads, and it's like trying to start right now, but it hasn't like fully latched on, so I guess that's a good thing. Made my commute less hectic, I guess, which is already sort of crazy without bad weather, but hopefully it won't be too bad today. Out there. Anyway, so lots of stuff going on lately. As far as personally, about to finish up this damn 10-page paper and submit that so my teacher can be happy to hear me gush on Linux. He kind of fucked me up the other day. I told this story, I think, on Twitter and Facebook. I don't know if I said it here, but it was crazy how I asked him about an error in the lab, and he sends me the answers. And I'm like, dude, I just need to know, are you familiar with this error? And do you have any suggestions? Anyway, I figured it out and got the answers on my own. So I didn't need his help, I guess, because he wasn't very helpful at all. So it's going to be interesting to see how this damn paper gets scored. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys. I'm not even putting in a full effort at this point when it comes to that damn paper. Because he pissed me off so much with that bullshit. But yeah. Scorpio. So, the Project Scorpio specs got announced. Digital Foundry did a whole write up a couple of videos on it. I didn't watch the videos. I didn't read anything. I just looked at the specs and went, ah, that's cool. And kept it moving. I know a lot of people out here went nuts. Crazy videos. My timeline on Twitter was going crazy with people going back and forth. Especially with the people who are now all of a sudden PC heads. I fucking love the reaction of people who just realized that, hey, PC is the most powerful platform to game on, and you get a wider array of options and performance than you do on consoles. Gee, golly, it's like all of a sudden now they're super duper PC experts, which is fine. I mean, I understand because I kind of had that experience back in the day. Like, I used to just play on PC. For those who don't know, I never had a PlayStation 2 or GameCube or an original Xbox. I never had none of those consoles during that generation because I was just on PC doing my thing. Mind you, I still had an affinity for consoles, in particular PlayStation, because I love the, like, games that they would come out. They're exclusives. But I never was compelled enough to go buy one because I was happy with my PC experience. And then, of course, I got a PS3 for Christmas in 2009. And now I've pretty much been mostly console. I go back and play certain things on PC now and again. But for the most part, I'm comfortable being back on console, because while I love PC gaming, I'm just not interested in spending the money to get the type of performance or I guess be like I used to be, because I used to be that guy who felt the need to constantly upgrade and keep getting the best thing so I can get the best performance. It's not worth it to me at this point in my life. I'm older. I'm happy just playing a game. And I'm even more so happy playing a good game. Not necessarily a good looking game, if that makes sense. Not saying that console games look bad. I think that's the biggest problem that I have with the whole PC versus console argument now, is that maybe it was the same back in the day. It probably was, and when I think about it. But I think it's more so now because technology advanced to a point where it's just really the gap has widened, that the argument becomes stronger on the PC side. But, you know, I'm comfortable with just putting the disc in, downloading a few patches, and knowing that, you know, unless the patch breaks it or the coding is horrible, my shit's gonna work and run fine. I don't need to do any tweaking or adjustments on my console settings. Sometimes on the PC, you have to do that. You have to play around to get things working right or the way that you want it to. And it's just like I'm comfortable with the more plug-and-play style of gaming right now. That's all. Even though, again, still love PC, still think. I still agree. From a technical standpoint, it's the best platform to play on, especially if you're somebody who are all about the numbers, all about the performance, all about those measurables. Stay on PC, but if you're just in it to play good games, I honestly don't think you need a PC. Maybe if you want to play some of the older games that you missed from back in the day and get them at a little more affordable. I think that's the biggest thing. Like for me, that would be the biggest argument for me to still maintain a PC, is that I can go back and play some really, really cool old games for dirt cheap. Other than that, I'm good with the new shit on console, to be quite honest. But anyway, Scorpio was the point of that whole bit right there, and the specs look cool. It's an interesting gamble for Microsoft, because they put themselves in a middle position where, yes, you're the most powerful console on the market once you drop, but as people have been saying a lot recently, what's your content? Microsoft came out with the Xbox One boasting that they had like 14, 15 studios working on a multitude of exclusive games for their platform. We've seen a bunch of them get canceled since then. Some that aren't canceled haven't gotten much press. We could expect one of those games to be shown probably at E3, Crackdown 3, which had boasted the fact that it was going to show people how using cloud technology on the Xbox One would show how great cloud technology can advance gaming and all of that, and neither hide nor hair really of that game. Then you got Forza, which was the game I think they showed. I don't know if they showed pictures or video, but like I said, I really wasn't that crazy about the notion, because again, I've gotten over the whole more power thing when it comes to gaming. That's just me. But anyway, but they said they show Forza stuff. It looks clean. It looks good. It's supposed to be a native 4K system. Okay. That's cool. 4K Blu-ray. Yeah, but again, the only reason I've never owned an Xbox at all, because I never thought that their library was that interesting enough to own. And that's just me. And it's going to be interesting to see how they move forward, since right now Sony still has the lion's share of third-party exclusive stuff. You know, that nasty little business where people buy exclusivity periods for DLC and all that shit. It's a lame practice, for sure. Sadly, it's a practice that Microsoft, though, kind of, made extremely popular during the last generation when the 360 pretty much dominated off the fact that you mainly got stuff first there, and third parties kind of catered more to their brand, you know? Now it's the other way around, and we realize Microsoft really don't have anything on their own outside of Halo and Gears for the most part, because we don't know if they're going to do another Fable. Well, Forza. I keep forgetting Forza. Forza's probably the strongest product right now. But, yeah. They're not a huge first-party producer. They're limited now on their second and third-party exclusives. So now it's... I don't know what's the selling point other than more power. You know what I mean? That's how I see the Scorpio. It's like the Scorpio's whole thing right now is I'm a better machine than you. That's it. So, but we'll see. Microsoft will figure it out. It's going to be a long-ass video, by the way, people. Third thing, of course, is the YouTube shit. YouTube, you know, and their changes. So they've announced YouTube TV, which I'm not surprised. It's a fucking sign. It was a sign that I saw coming once they started making these changes with YouTube Red and all of that. The way that they reworked their distribution. You notice, like, when YouTube Red came out, the live share distribution was going to people like musicians and things like that. They're more dedicated to more higher value production and more popular, universally popular content creators, such as musicians, television personalities, things like that. Sure, some of the larger YouTubers are going to still always get love, but for the most part, they've been moving towards this thing now where now you have YouTube TV where you can subscribe and watch different channels with YouTube. And then they announced that if you don't have 10,000 views on your channel, they're not going to support your channel with ads. They want to make sure your channel is viable enough to start giving ad support and giving you an opportunity to use things like AdSense or a partnership to make ad revenue. So, yeah, I'm not surprised. Like I said before, they've been always heading towards this more long-form, higher production value, more TV-like medium. You know, that's what they want because longer-form stuff gives you more opportunities for advertisements, a more higher value, high class, quote unquote, respectable type of material is more attractive to advertisers. You know, it's not to me. It does not surprise me how the whole PewDiePie thing went down even more so now, because hey, that's not what they want representing their brand anymore. The crazy, wild shit that he do, the just a prank bro shit, that's not who they want to sell to. Before, it was just all about, hey, we got numbers, you guys should give us ads. And companies were fine with that because they were just looking at the numbers. But now, no, it's not just about the numbers. It's also who they got representing them, where the numbers are coming from, and what type of viewer or what type of viewers viewing their products, and what type of content creator is representing their product. They don't want that shit no more. So that whole shit right there, it'll fly for some brands, but I expect ad revenue for people like that to drop more. You'll see views keep going. For the drama and bullshit like that. But for the most, but their money's gonna drop. Their money's gonna really drop. And you know, YouTube as we know it is now gone, people. That's it. You know, it was a hell of a ride at first, but now, you know, things have changed. They've evolved into something else. They're moving to a more mature, stereotypical business-like platform. You know, it's all about money, and they got to protect themselves and their investors. So, hey, it is what it is. Lastly, as I move into the 16th minute of the video, goddamn, shows you how long I'm waiting to go to work. Anyway, so we bombed Syria because Syria's civil war got nasty. The president of Syria decided to use chemical attacks on the rebels, killing innocent civilians in the process. So our president, in a desperate attempt to distract from his bullshit, decided, hey, let me go over here and bomb them in retaliation. Mind you, they did nothing to us, had nothing to do with us, but he insinuated us in a civil war. Now Russia's coming at us saying, oh, well, we're going to send them protection and shore up their defenses. Now what? Do it again. And that man's hubris, to me, I think will encourage him to do it again, or at least to try something else stupid, because he needs a distraction. War has always been a big, big business, a big way to distract us from paying attention to things that we don't like. And he's setting it off by dropping those bombs. Now we're all upset. So all the bullshit that's going on around with the Russia thing, the spy, or the whole Russia helping him, his ties to them, all the fucking executive orders that he's been signing that are dumb as fuck, so on and so forth. That stuff might get passed now because we're so concerned now. Because people are going to be frightened. It's like, yo, are we about to start World War III? Is this really fucking happening? Who knows? That guy's a nut. Too bad our Congress is full of a bunch of children that can't get along, and also is being led by a group of people who are more concerned about breaking the previous president's legacy and establishing dominance than fucking doing what's right for us as a nation. That he's gonna go and do some really fucked up shit, and then they're not gonna know what to do because they can't turn it back. Just hopefully they'll get their acts together and they'll actually do their jobs. Because, hey, we're coming up on an election year next year for Congress that's gonna be big, and there's gotta be some big changes in this country. The way that they behave, the way that we pay attention, and, you know, make sure these people do what we put them in office to do. All of that. It has to be a big change. But anyway, I think I'm ready to go to work now. So, as always, feel free to hit me up. Let me know what you're thinking. I'll holler at you later. This your boy, Black Megas, and I'm out, y'all. Deuces.